This is Frasier the Lion. You can tell it's him because his tongue is hanging out. See? There it is. Also, because he's about to mate. Have you ever wondered about the number of lions at your zoo? You probably don't think about lion reproduction too much, do you? Well, consider this. If one female lion in captivity has a litter of cubs, and they all survive and breed, for reference, zoo lions can start breeding before their third birthday. And then those offspring all survive and breed, and then the next generation the same, and so on. It'd take about 37 years until that one family tree of descendants from that one lioness needed to eat the entire population of Los Angeles every day just to survive. That is why zoos in the United States so often administer birth control to their animals. Chimps take the pill, same one humans use. Giraffes get hormones in their food, while lions, who would otherwise take over LA, have slow-release hormone implants. Or it's as simple as keeping males and females of the same species separate. Populations are kept in check. Breeding, when it happens, is controlled. Pairs are matched based on their genetic makeup, which sometimes means a sort of mail order mate. There could be a rhinoceros flying overhead right now, on her way to see if some male rhino measures up. Isn't there something kind of wonderful about that? But there was a time before all this copulation regulation. Let me tell you a story about a lion that actually did take over Los Angeles. His name is Frasier. Remember the lion with the hangdog tongue? Frasier the Sensuous Lion.
And now, Clyde Beatty, the most fearless man in all the world, alone in a cage with a herd of man-eating African lions.
Frasier was a circus lion for years, until 1970, when the Mexican circus that owned him went out of business. Here was Frasier, age 19, old for a lion, circus or otherwise, by all accounts, done for, said to be put down. Toothless, 100 pounds underweight, his tongue always out because the muscles that held it gave way. Poor Frasier. But it wasn't the end for the old Panthera Leo. Somehow he wound up in a shipment of big cats bought on consignment from the circus and bound for Lion Country Safari, a drive-through animal preserve in Laguna Hills, California, just south of LA. The events from here on unfolded in a thoroughly unexpected way.
I was on NBC because of the old guy. Wasn't it Frasier the Lion? Frasier the Lion was mating a female during that time, as old as he was. But anyway.
That is Pat Quinn, the former wildlife director at Lion Country. In 1972, Pat was on TV because in less than a year and a half at the safari, Frasier fathered 31 cubs with six lionesses. One of those lionesses was named Linda. In the wild, a lion lives 10, maybe 15 years. In captivity, 30 is possible. As for Frasier's 19 years, picture Grandpa having 30-plus toddlers. Frasier, to say the least, was prolific. As the LA Times reported at the time, quote, "It takes an ordinary male lion 18 months to father maybe only 12 cubs." Frasier had more than doubled that rate. Pat's wife Donna also remembers Frasier.
I just know that they made a movie about him. I think it bombed. I don't think it did well. You know, he was famous for a frequent copulation, but that's normal with lions. Now, I see no reason why a 20-year-old lion, if it's horny, doesn't mate often.
The movie, Frasier the Sensuous Lion, was later renamed Frasier the Lovable Lion, A talking animal movie in which Frasier instructs a virgin scientist how to seduce women.
Good morning, Frasier.
Quite a female you have there, Marvin. Looks right.
She works here in public relations.
I think she really likes you.
Oh, Frasier, really?
No, I can tell. Has she licked your ear yet?
Frasier.
Well, that's the way my females let me know when they're ready for a little jungle joy.
Like Mrs. Quinn said, it bombed. He was a lion celebrity. A photo spread in Life magazine, a ballad by Oscar-winning songwriter Johnny Mercer, and a recording of that song by jazz legend Sarah Vaughan. Here, I'll play it for you.
Oh, cruel is fate, but it's never too late, said Frasier. Announce the feast, I'm the king of the beast, yawned Frasier. But king or not, I am certainly hot when Frasier. And when you are hot and are hitting the spot, the action will amaze you.
Also, fan mail came at a rate of 1,500 letters a month, many from old men inquiring about the lion's diet.
If I recollect, I know they were trying to introduce some younger males to a group of females, but the problem with that is they would end up fighting and someone's going to die.
The Quinn's son, Todd, also worked for Lion Country Safari. What he said confirms a lyric in the Frasier song.
Younger studs brought in for breeding, wound up beaten, bruised, and bleeding. Every dawn the same thing kept occurring.
According to Life magazine, the safari was trying to have their lionesses start a family. Quote, attempts to introduce strapping young males to the group failed. As a joke, someone suggested Frasier. The next day, Frasier was on his back surrounded by lionesses. The females even brought him food and stood guard. He was pride king, seemingly defying Darwin's theories on survival of the fittest. The LA Times reported, wife after wife turned up pregnant.
I mean, having your tongue hanging out like that cannot be a sign of good genetic health.
That's Dr. Craig Packer, professor and head of the Lion Center at the University of Minnesota. He has a theory on Frasier's sex appeal.
So lions, like a lot of other animal species, have a sort of innate incest taboo. If those young males were in any way genetically related to the females in that colony, then there would have been very little sexual interest. So if animals have grown up together, they make the assumption that they're siblings, and they're just not turned on.
Just to interrupt, Todd Quinn recalled how Frasier was the only newcomer, that the rest were raised together since they were cubs.
In this case, a stranger comes to town, and that can really excite all the ladies. That's what I guess happened, because he certainly was no impressive physical specimen. Frasier, who's 19 years old, you would think he would not present as a good bet for surviving the next 2 years.
He didn't. In the end, Frasier died on July 13th, 1972, 2 months after Life magazine published his photo spread. An old circus lion turned sex symbol. In under 2 years, he had 35 cubs in total with 7 lionesses. Also, a movie and a song. The LA Times published an account of Frasier's autopsy, which reads like a search for the fountain of youth. 15 scientists performed the postmortem. He had, quote, beautiful organs. His prostate, kidneys, liver, heart, and cardiovascular system were perfectly healthy. Externally, they wrote, Frasier wasn't much to look at, but internally, well, he was just remarkable. The team even took tissue samples for further study. The official cause of death was pneumonia. Though one doctor offered another cause, I feel he loved himself to death. Also, subscribe to Popular Science on YouTube for more Wildlives episodes. Next up, Alfred Hitchcock's classic, The Birds, isn't entirely fiction.